Good morning. Today we are going to demonstrate an experiment based on the magnetic effects of current. Okay? So the aim of the experiment is to study the variation of magnetic field due to a circular current carrying coil on an axial position. Okay? We will also find out the radius of the coil which is creating the magnetic field, and we will verify the principle of superposition by taking two coils and then verifying the result theoretically as well as practically. So, to start with, after the discovery of Oersted, which showed that current carrying conductors create a magnetic field around it, Biot and Savart gave a law for the mathematical formulation or mathematical determination of the magnetic field created by a small current element, IBL. So this for, this law says that dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi IDL cross R upon R cube, where IDL is the current element and R is the distance of the point where magnetic field is found, is to be found from the current element. So this is the formula, and the direction of this is given by right hand screw rule or right hand thumb rule. So this is the basic mathematical relation for the magnetic field due to a current element. But current element can current carrying conductor can be in various forms, for example a straight current carrying conductor or a circular current carrying conductor or rectangular or semicircular and so on. So we put the proper conditions and integrate this relation to get the relation for that particular current carrying conductor. So when we, here we are interested in circular current carrying conductor. So when we put the proper conditions over that and integrate it, we get a relation B is equal to mu naught upon 4, mu naught upon 2 I A square, X square plus A square raised to the power 3 by 2. Where X is the distance of point P from the center of the coil. P is at a distance of X from the center of the coil, and the direction is given by right hand thumb rule, and which comes out to be away from the either away from the from the along this axis or towards the axis depending on the direction of current flowing in the conductor. Now if I put X is equal to 0 in this, that is I reach at center. Okay, so at center, if I put X is equal to 0, I can, from this formula, I get B is equal to mu naught I upon 2A. So this is the formula of the magnetic field at the center of a circular current carrying coil. If I know the current and the corresponding magnetic field, I can find out the radius of the coil, which is our second aim. Here one thing more, that if we have n number of turns in a coil, so this formula will be multiplied by a factor of n. Similarly, this formula will also be multiplied by the factor of n. So now let us see that how we can, I will first discuss the two first aims with the help of, this is our experimental setup. This is the basic unit which sends the current. This is the wire which is connected to this. So this this is providing current to these two coils. Here I am at moment I am just working with this first coil, and this is the magnetic field display panel, this one, which is connected to the sensor. So this is our sensor, which can be moved, its position can be changed with the help of this knob. So what we can do is we can take it to one side of the coil, and then we will switch on this. The first thing we need to do here is to start with any experiment or with any of the device. First thing we must see the zero adjustment. So that is when there is no current. For example, in this case there is no current, means there it should not show any magnetic field. So we will put place, we will put the value of current as 0, and then the corresponding magnetic field should also be 0. So this is our zero adjustment. After zero adjusting, we will give some amount of current here with the help of this knob, and then corresponding magnetic field will be observed with different positions of the sensor. We will get the magnetic field at the different positions. For example, let me come this side. So the current is 300 milliamperes, and this is showing 5.7 gauss. So when the current is 300 milliamperes in this coil, because this is at the coil number 1 position, the magnetic field is 5.7 gauss. I will now shift the position of the coil by 1 centimeter. And then I will note down the magnetic field, which is 5.3. Then again, we will shift it again by 1 centimeter. Then the magnetic field will be changed. That will be noted down. So we will take a number of readings as close as possible so that we get a smooth curve. For this coil, from this side, means from one side of the coil to the other side of the coil. So we are taking magnetic field measurement in this range from one side to the other side of the coil, and we will plot this. So after taking the readings for the magnetic field at an for current 300 milliamperes, we have noted down the readings and plotted this graph for a single coil. So this shows this type of variation. The first thing we observe from here, we have to study this graph actually. So first thing we observe from here is that the magnetic field varies symmetrically on either side of the coil. It is maximum at the center and goes on decreasing on either side of the coil. Then we observe that at this point, that is near the center, we have magnetic field varies, it is convex towards the center. The curvature goes on changing, it changes its sign, and here it is concave towards the center. So this point, we define two points P and Q where it changes its curvature. So these two points are known as point of inflection, and it is seen that they are at a distance of A by 2 from the center. So these are our observations from the magnetic field due to a circular current carrying coil. Let us see how do we manipulate these observations and this concept for some useful applications. So now I am again coming to this. Initially we have seen this data for the single coil. Now, I am taking the other coil also into consideration. Note that these two are identical coils. They are same. Their radius is same. The number of turns in each of the coil is same. The same amount of, they are connected in series. So, same amount of current is flowing through it. And the direction of the current is also same. So, they are perfectly identical in nature. So, if we keep these two these two coils at a distance of A. A is the radius of the coil. So if they are separated by their distance, then let us see what is the behavior of the magnetic field. So again, we will follow the same procedure. We will take this to one of the end sensor, and then the current is 300 milliamperes. Now the function of this comes out to be, the function of this is now is useful. That is, this is for coil 1. If I flick it, it is for coil 2, and then for both the coils. Okay, so first I put it for coil 1. Now these are kept at a distance of A, which can be done. We have an option to change the distance between the two. And then again the readings are taken. So first I will take the reading for first coil. The position of the sensor is this. Suppose it is minus 5 centimeter, that is 5 centimeter on the right of the coil. Then note down the current, note down the magnetic field in gauss. Then I shift it to this. You can see that the value of the magnetic field has changed. And then note down this also for coil 2. And then I flick it again. This is for both the coil. So the now the magnetic field which here is showing is that at this point due to both the coils. Okay. Now again we shift the position of the this sensor and see that how much is the magnetic field. So after noting down this, we plot, write the observation in this type of table, where this is the position of the sensor, this is the magnetic field due to the first coil at this position in gauss, then again the magnetic field due to second coil at the same position, and this is the magnetic field due to both the coils at the same position. So for each and every value, we can just check whether the value is coming, it is 8.7, then 2.1. So according to theory, it should come out to be 8.7 plus 2.1, it is 10.8. And the value we are getting as here as 10.7. So it is very close to the expected value. So we can say that the principle of superposition is being followed. Second thing which we observe is, then when we come near center of the coil, this value, that is the magnetic field due to both the coils, it is same over. So it means the magnetic field we are getting is uniform over, means in between the coils. So this is a very important result which we can use to get a uniform magnetic field at any place. So let us discuss it here. So this is the magnetic field. Here we are showing the distance, and here we have the magnetic field intensity in gauss. So this is the magnetic field due to the first one, magnetic field due to the second one. When they are placed at a distance equal to radius, the magnetic field comes out to be something this. The magnetic field is definitely, it is increased, and it has, can be seen that it is uniform in this range. So this range can be used to produce the uniform magnetic field. To get anything wherever we need uniform magnetic field, these coils can be used. So this is all about the experiment. That is, we have studied the first thing. We can determine the radius of the coil also. We can take the value of magnetic field from here, which is at the center, and then substitute the value here. We know the number of turns. We know the amount of current. So A can be found. So we have determined the radius of the coil. Also, we have verified the principle of superposition. So this type of arrangement in which two identical coils carrying same amount of current in same direction are placed at a distance of either of the radius of the coil is known as Helmholtz coil arrangement. Okay, this particular arrangement is known as Helmholtz coil arrangement. So this is all about the experiment. Now let us discuss some precautions. So the precaution, first precaution is we should set the zero position. That is, for zero current, the magnetic field should show as zero. So this is the first precaution we have to follow. Secondly, the reading should be taken as close as possible so that we get a uniform curve and a proper shape of the curve. Third thing is that in between we have to keep a check on the amount of current, that is whether the current is okay or not, whether we are, because we have already noted down 300 milliamperes, so it should remain 300 milliamperes all through, otherwise the magnetic field will change due to the magnetic field as well, due to the current as well, which we are not taking into account. We are just seeing the variation of this position. And the last thing is that we should keep this along east-west direction to avoid any effect due to Earth's horizontal component. So with the help of a compass, we can find out the north side direction. We place this perpendicular to that is in east west direction. So our readings are will be more or less free from any other external field. And obviously there should not be any magnetic field around, any no magnetic material should be around. So these are the precautions we have to keep. Now I can suggest to you that we should perform this experiment by taking this the distance of the coils more than A and then less than A. What happens? This is an activity left to all of you. Thank you and have a nice day.